Welcome back to my channel. This is Shipa and you're watching Shipa's Diary. And today I'll be going to this mansion right over there. The owner of this mansion was killed, or you can say murdered, by her daughter's husband, I guess. So we'll now go inside it and show you guys what's in there. It's a more than 100 years old and it's amazing. Like how old this house, but still how modern inside it. And I didn't want it to continue my vlogs, but I saw that you guys were like really liking my vlogs, so I just decided to do this one little ones. And yeah, follow me there. So this is the Glenshin Mansion where I'm gonna take you guys today. And this mansion was built in 1905 through 1908, so which was like 115 years ago, built by that very rich guy. And then later his wife and his daughter Elizabeth Congdon got this mansion. And then this Elizabeth Congdon was murdered in this mansion by her daughter's husband. Probably her daughter's husband was hoping to have this mansion after Elizabeth's death, but it didn't happen that way. After Elizabeth's death, they found that this mansion was given to the University of Duluth. After 2 years of her death, this house was open for public, for visitors, and till today, University of Duluth runs this. This is crowning the example of design and craftsmanship of the Midwest in the early 20th century. This house is literally a piece of art's masterpiece and telling you the story of a luxurious house and luxurious living, and also telling you the story of Northland's mining history. Look at this place, of like how well preserved this place, and I love this place so much, especially this room. This is the breakfast room. So yeah, the view from here is just wonderful. You can see the North Shore from sitting here, and that's the breakfast room, like just I mentioned. And look at this beautiful corridor, you can walk around, and then there is the waterfall. This is just such a wonderful place of history, art, family story, luxury, everything. Wonderful. So here is the steps that you can take to go to this garden and that water fountain. And right over there was that place where I showed you guys the breakfast room. So yeah, this is a gorgeous place. And then we stayed here quite a few hours, and then we went to have our lunch. And we went to a wonderful place for lunch. I love that place. It's called Grandma Saloon and Grill. Here is the place. This is a wonderful place. I highly recommend this place. The foods are amazing. After eating the lunch, we went to take a scenic rail ride, and right next to the rail lines they had this beautiful rail museum, and so we went there. It is a miniature rail lines of the past. It's like some of the trains here are like 120 years old. And it's kind of amazing and really cool piece of art. Like each of those trains, like they're super old, and then they use them as a museum and they put stuff inside it, so you can walk around the trains inside it, and it has all those history and a lot of really cool historical things. Right now I'm inside one of those 120 years old train. And this train is like a museum right now. It holds a lot of history. For example, here you can see some of the stories. And this little chamber over here is a mail carrier. They used to carry mails in this chamber. That's so cool. And then the scenic rail ride was another very wonderful and pleasant ride. And if you have kids, they're gonna love it. Thank you.
properly designed.
So overall, this was a really cool place to visit. I took a lot of wonderful pictures for my Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you back again in another video. Please subscribe to my channel and be a part of my YouTube family. Bye bye.